Hey, what's up everybody? Exul's Extreme here, and today we're going to be taking up the C-130 Hercules by Captain Sim. So this thing was on sale on the Sims Market for $15. It's an external only, but it actually does have a cockpit. So we will show that out, of course, and we'll show everything about it. And I'll show the ground services, which we're doing right now. See if we call the ground services. We can get the doors to open and all that cool stuff. So go ahead and basically do an entire flight from Travis Air Force Base all the way to Las Vegas, to Nellis Air Force Base. And so we'll load up our cargo right now. So we've got our ground crew loading up our cargo, which you can do through your ATC menu by contacting the ground crew and then requesting them to load up your cargo with suitcases, which you can see them doing right here. Be cool if they had like a military one where they put like, you know, actual tanks in there or something. That'd be cool. But for now, this is what we got. And this is the only way to open up the cargo doors, by the way, is on the ground when you're parked, and you can access the cargo services. So it has to be an airport that has cargo services as well. But it does look pretty cool, though. Like how the they're putting in like normal suitcases in there. It's pretty awesome. Gotta like it. Hey, what's up? I saw your comment. There you go. They're going up the conveyor belt. Yay! There's our suitcases. Sweet. So now that we got those loaded up, we'll go ahead and
Ground Badger 0811. Could you please
call for the top loader thing here. And it's cool because see, it opens up the engines. As you can see, it's like you're gonna repair the engines, basically. It's pretty awesome. It's also a food truck too, but that just pulls up to the back. It doesn't really open anything up, so. It would be nice if Microsoft Flight Simulator added the way to pair the doors for stuff, because this runs, this seems to be a problem on every plane that I buy. Like the Raptor, the doors, the bay doors, you can't open them externally without going into the cockpit. And because this doesn't have a modeled cockpit all the way, there's no way to actually open the doors when you're flying other than this way, so. In the previous versions of Microsoft Flight Simulator, you could open up the cargo bay doors and stuff, so. I don't know. It'd be cool if they added it. It's pretty cool, the modeling of it. Like I said, it'd be cool if they did like a military ground crew, but this is what we have for now. So we're at Travis Air Force Base. And this is the upgraded version of Travis Air Force Base 2, so you do have all the models on the ground of the C-5s and C-17s and stuff, so. And you can see the big
ground
doors
Badger,
closing right
0811.
Now.
I am done with the ramp.
Awesome.
Ground Badger,
you can see
0811.
We're flying
I am done
with a Oklahoma
services.
City livery today. Pretty cool, man. That's a nice thing. You can download a bunch of libraries for this on sim.to. They had a ton of them, which was cool. It was easy to install. You just install it in your community folder, so. It's awesome looking. Yeah, very cool. Also, we gotta get the engine started. We'll go ahead and press the start all button, which you can pair through the settings. I'm going to do a tutorial about it. I was working on it today, actually. It's kind of in depth, so I wanted to show everything so I wasn't finished with it. Because you have to do the cold start so you can use the cargo bay. So you have to basically be able to start the jet, or start the, not jet, propellers. seeing with the airships, just walking through them and everything. We went up to the top the last time when the car crashed and everything, so it was really cool. Alright, so ground services, you can see all the list of the ground services. And we're gonna do taxi. I just wanted to do my normal, how I was going to do it though.
Ground Badger 0811 with Charlie request taxi to
that's
the active touch.
There's
and
a
go.
Lot of options there.
Badger 0811.
Stuff hold all short around. Runway 21 left oh, via taxiway Alpha cross runway 21 left Delta Badger 0811.
So you will have to have all your buttons paired. If they were previously paired for other aircrafts, it's fine. Like I have everything seemed to work. My e-brake came off fine. Go ahead and taxi. There's a couple other jets out here right now too. That's a cool thing if you go and you play Microsoft Flight Simulator and you put it so you're on multiplayer and you go to like hang out at Nellis or Travis Air Force Base, a lot of times there are other people out here playing as well too, and you can fly with them, you can get in a formation with them and do cool stuff like so. Hey, what's up, Venktesh? How you doing tonight? We're gonna be flying the C-30 here if we can get it off the runway. And then we'll get up and we'll show some aerial views, and I'll show the inside of it too. There is, I know they say it doesn't have a cockpit, but it does. I like this thing. I mean, it got bad reviews, but I'd give it like 4.5 stars just because it's fun to fly. And there's nothing like this else really in the game, military-wise. So. Let's try to hold the rudder pedals and rock. They're really touchy on this thing. It's hard to stay right in the center line. Could be worse. I think it's supposed to take off the other way anyways. Air traffic control's gonna be pissed. It's like flaps when they go down. It's weird. I was like, I have them. Like, no, when they finally went all the way down. You can see it has really nice flaps. You have to keep on rolling them down.
Travis approach Badger 0811.
I don't know how you have the flaps set up.
Mine are
on
the
lower bar and Logitech. X56 and the throttle and the lower bowl of things that just roll the flaps back and forth.
Squawk 0212 Badger 0811.
Back
in, but Badger 0811 radar contact.
There'll probably be a bunch when we get into Vegas. I notice there's always a lot of people around that airport, around Nellis. It's actually a cool place to hang out. You can buy the upgrade port for the modeling for both bases on Microsoft Flight Sim Store, or you can download them for free on flightsim.to. The free part is there. Is the best part. So So we'll get this thing up, and then I will I'll switch it over into autopilot a little bit, and then I can show some of the outside of it. I can get a bunch of different camera angles and stuff. I want to make sure I have a little bit of altitude that's facing the right direction, because sometimes autopilot's weird, and I've had trouble getting it out of autopilot lately, so it says that it's out. Sketching me out. This is the flight the right way, I guess. No, it's not. It's going back the other way. It should be going up, man. Yep, we got turned back on. Autopilot. It was weird too, because it was turning it the wrong direction. It wouldn't let me turn it, and it kind of pulled back. Because at first it seemed like it was doing what I was doing, so I didn't notice, and then all of a sudden it was pretty prevalent that the jet was the plane going the wrong direction. So nice that we got that figured out. Oh yeah, never trust autopilot for landings, ever. It will never land right, ever. I want to go up one of these someday. Man, that would be so cool. My dad, when he was in the military, he got to go up to C-130 a bunch of times.
Travis, approach Badger 0811 4,700 feet.
Badger 0811, Travis, approach altimeter 29.92. Continue as planned.
See some. We'll check out some of the other views too. So here's the inside of the cockpit. As you can see, it's somewhat modeled, and you can actually go get some of the texture packages and make it look better. But they're still blurry, so I was like, what's the point? It doesn't seem like it'd be too hard to model the cockpit at this point. I mean, there's the communications desk right there, and then there's like the bunk, which you can climb up on top, and that's how you go through the roof too. So and there's like the little hallway right there. And let's see if I can go down. Yeah, there's the stairway that goes outside. I'm trying to go around this corner. It's not really letting me. There we go. And then here's the cargo bay. So it's all pretty much modeled, you know. I mean, it's all there. You can fly the plane from the seat too. You can sit here and fly it. can see your hands are on the steering wheel. It's just like they didn't finish the cockpit, basically. They wanted 15 instead of 30 or 35. They could have gotten twice as much money had they finished it. This view here is cool.
Oakland Center, Badger 0811 9000 feet.
I don't like that because you're behind that. Yeah. Hey, what's up, Gerald? Going? Yeah, really, man. A bunch of different camera views you can get. You can rotate around and stuff. So I don't really know. I have my buttons configured to like a lot of the external cameras. So let's see what we can do here. Oh, that's cool. You can kind of do it at the top. Of course, it's kind of zoomed in. And then you got the back view, like if you're trying to fly it, basically. You can pan out on this one, which is cool. Go around. This is probably the showcase camera. I have my Xbox 360 controller going too, so I can grab that real quick and flip around, as well as the Logitech X56, the little analog stick on the flight stick itself is pretty good too. You can rotate around with that. I haven't got the one on the throttle to work yet, but that would be cool if I could get that one to work too. So inside the cockpit again. It's a cool view. It's a little hazy out. A little hazy. It's like a purple haze. But they did model the outside of it really well. Because I'd say that was my complaint about the Bedrock version of the F-22. It's like when you looked at the outside, it wasn't modeled all that well. And then it floats, it flies like crap too, but compared to the top mock version, but we won't talk about that. We'll talk about Flight Club. And this thing actually looks pretty decent. It does help that Microsoft had an update and they remodeled some of the ground. So that definitely has helped some of the scenery. But then I've heard that people are complaining about the lag more, so now it's more laggy. It's like after every update, right? Let's see here. I'm gonna see if I can clear up the haze. See if we can get rid of the purple haze. We'll go to the clear skies. Where is it? Still about the same. Hey, what's up, Nate? How you doing tonight? We're flying this Hercules from Travis Air Force Base out to Las Vegas to Nellis Air Force Base. Doing the full flight, and I will attempt a landing. Yes, this is live. I will attempt the landing. You sure as hell aren't using autopilot to do it. You saw that display on takeoff. I was like, well, I'll switch it on so I can, and just like goes the opposite direction, starts curving the other way. It's like, what are you doing? I don't know if it was gonna like circle around the airport a couple times. It was really low altitude too. Oh, that's awesome, Nate. Thanks a lot, man. Appreciate it. So this is the Captain Sims, kind of an updated version of the Hercules. I guess they re-released it. The modeling's really good on the outside, and there is somewhat of a cockpit as well, too, which I've been showing. So now I'm kind of just going through all the camera things, so. I have an Xbox. I don't actually play on Xbox, though. I play on PC. That was cool, the way the wings bobbing back and forth. That's a cool camera angle. Yeah, I like this. You can see the modeling of the ground is better now, too. Look at it. It looks, like, real. So, that was with the last update. Of course, you do have to have all the, like, updates installed for each of the continents, too. Like, the updated USA, so you have to have that update installed, too. I think Microsoft Simulator right now is, like, over 500 gigabytes. I didn't even think it would fit on an Xbox. Nah, you can play it on an Xbox. It doesn't run that well, though. Maybe it doesn't on a new one, though. Here's that top version. Yeah, that looks pretty good. United States Air Force, aim high. It's no secret, that's my favorite branch of the service. Day, every day. Yeah, it's such a cool angle with the wing bobbing. You turn on the lights too, but it doesn't seem to be turning on the wing light. You can press L. Oh, do I want to sell my Xbox? Well, it's not the new one, it's the older one. It's not actually mine, it's my son's. I have a PlayStation 5, which I don't really play that much either, but... Man, that is a nice looking tail. Oklahoma City. Of course, we're flying from California to Nevada, but... They don't have a skin yet for... Travis or Fenelis, or I was kind of surprised, and those are some of the biggest ones. Oh yeah, the SnowRunner. That's a cool game, actually, too. I have it on PC. I haven't played it for a long time, though. I have so many games. It's just like on this, I spent so much money buying these jets. We just bought the Raptor, the top lock, and then we bought this at the same time. Yeah, the Xbox X, that one's cool. I've seen some videos of people playing Microsoft Flight Simulator on there, and it runs pretty well. I mean, it's not as good as PC, but... Well, this is the inside of the unmodeled cockpit. It's pretty cool though, because you can see it has potential if they do want to finish it. Man, I feel like, I have images of all of these planes, and I've been in the cockpits and stuff. It's like, dude, I could probably like model this. So cool with all those windows. beautiful looking plane. Beautiful. Yeah, it was worth the $15. Man, I've had a hell of a fun playing with this thing. Probably wasted a lot more time than I should have, let's put it that way. Oh, I'm in California. I'm in Sacramento. Actually, right by Mather Field, formerly Mather Air Force Base. They kind of moved all the heavies out to Travis. So now all the KC-135s and the C-5s and C-17s and, of course, the Hercules are all over there at Travis Air Force Base. Not that far from me. Yeah, that looks really good right there too. I have a bunch of the heavies up at Beale. All the fighters are down south. Not necessarily though, because they have the California National Guard and they have F-15s. So they'll fly the F-15s a lot here, and they'll fly the Talons, L-39s. Yeah, it's like 12:30. It's pretty much normally when I stream late night. I'm a dad, so you know, I have a kid, and then I had to take him rock climbing, and then we had to do like 50 by the time, you know, I actually get home and stuff, and like get a chance, that's why. Like, screw it. Plus, like, a lot of people watch. Like, every time I stream at like 11 or 12, I'll end up with like, when I wake up in the morning, I'll have like 1,000 views or something, and like, if I stream during the day, no, it's like nobody watching, it's weird. Not that I'm around during the day, but man, that looks like real. Yeah, this is so cool, man. I like this plan. I'll put it down under recommended for sure. I still don't know why they wouldn't have done the cockpit though, because think about it, they could have charged. Probably gone premium, even gone like 40 or something, because there's nothing else like it. And then now they're just like $15, like. I went to look at it. I mean, it would have been that hard. Like, they have it here. They have the pilots. They have the seats. I don't know, man. It seems like they could have done it. I would have hired a dude. I would have been like, hey, man. We need you to come in here and model the cockpit. Like, that's a difference. It's like twice as much, basically. Because all the planes that come out now are over $30. And some of them, like the 737-800, that thing's like $80. It's like getting like X-plane prices. It's like excuse me. Man, she flies beautiful. Just flies right along, no problems, man, that's for sure. Isn't exciting like my normal streams, but it's a good looker. Normally, it's a lot different. I bet you though, when we get into Las Vegas, there's going to be a bunch of fighter jets. Watch. I guarantee it. Like, every time I go there, there's people flying. So. Oh, yeah, the Russia-Ukraine bombing video. Yep. Dude, there's so many people making videos from DCS and Arma 3. And then they don't even label them. And then people come in my videos and get all mad. And like says right in the title, it's like DCS. Plus, you know, you put them under categories. Like I always put mine under video game categories. So it's weird, man. I'll say like about 4 or 5 years ago, I think most of the videos I did were all like GTA or driving, or there were some sort of simulator and stuff, and nobody ever said anything. And then, yeah, we got Trump as president and fake news and all that shit. And then next thing you know, like every time, everybody's like, "This is fake." It's like, I'm not saying it's real. It's so funny, man. I love it, dude. I tell you what, though, the more people that comment, even if it's not good, it's like, if it is a video that's like fake for Russia and Ukraine, and then everybody gets pissed and they comment more and more, it just drives more people to the video, so that person just gets more and more views. But I know what you're talking about, though. I hate those videos too, because they don't even want to label them. It's like they're not even trying. Yeah, you have to pick a category. It's not like you can't pick a category when you upload a video. And I've noticed that a lot of those will be under travel. So they do try to make it seem like it's real. Because you can look. Yeah, it's weird, man. Dude, look at this thing. It's just flying perfectly. Straight. Can't do any high out of this. No loops.
Going to 121.25 Badger 0811. Lowland Center Badger 0811 flight level 295.
Badger 0811 Lowland Center, continue as planned.
Went up in the Cessna last Saturday. And you start doing the turns over. Just check things out or whatever, and then just with that G-force alone, you're like, whoa, now you think about a fighter jet. Yeah. It's a camera. I hate when it does that. Let's see, we got it leveled out. Yeah, fly by. That's cool. Try to catch up to it here. Get the drone camera going. No, I didn't see that video. Oh man, I'll go check that out. You can see right through the window, see? You can see the pilot's model in there too. You can see like the seams and stuff, everything is, it's done really well. And my computer is output 4K. So, and then I can only stream in 1440p. I tried to stream in 4K. I don't have the up. I have download speed. I have over a gig, but for upload, they don't you know how it is, they don't really give you shit for it, so I have like maybe 30, so I can't get the bandwidth to do 4K, so. Wow, that's good. It's modeled really well, though. You can see all the seams are done well and stuff. Man, I'm really surprised they would not have fixed the cockpit. They could have gotten so much more money for this thing. Plus, just people want it, you know? People want that cockpit. They want to fly it like it's the real thing. That's the whole, that's why we do simulators. We want the real jet. That's why people are pissed. Even though it was said, right, in the title, it says it's an external only. I think the last time I looked, it was like 1.2 stars. It's like, ooh, damn. They're getting that one bad. But you can see it's modeled really, for $15, it's totally worth it, to be honest. I mean, with all the planes are so much, let's see where we are here. Okay, well, I actually left the VFR map for a while, I guess. Let's see where we're at. Oh yeah, we got a ways to go. This is the Hercules. I wonder what the top speed is. Let's see. $366. That's not bad. I mean, considering it's a prop plane. It's interesting when it lands. Oh, sorry, Omar. Here's the inside. You can see the cockpit. Basically, this is the driver's thing. I was looking up the speed and stuff, looking at things. So they didn't really model the full thing, but it is kind of nice because you can see out the full windows. You can see there's the dash. It's not done, but it could be done. That's the thing. And they have pilots in here and stuff. So yeah, that's pretty cool. You can fly it from the cockpit. You can sit inside of there and do it, so it's not that bad. It could be way worse. I know some of the jets, when they say external only, they are literally external only. You can't even go in the cockpit. It's not modeled at all, so. There's some cool games on their phone. There's a ton of them. My son keeps on making me buy a bunch of them for him. I don't play any games on my phone. I mean, number one, I don't have time. And number two, my phone is like full of videos and photos and stuff all the time, so there's the pilots. You can see sort of in the back here, you get this back view. There's all the seats are in here as well, so you can see it's even got the top panel. So the insides, like I said, it's not horrible. It could be way worse, that's for sure. But as far as like Microsoft Flight Simulator standards, it's, yeah, not up to standards. That's why people are pissed. But I'm not. I think it's awesome, and I would recommend it because it's fun to fly. And it looks really good from the outside, and that's what mostly people want to see anyways, but... I like how both the dudes are the same, like, you have to turn off your cockpit guys too, by the way, in the settings, otherwise it loads them on top of them, so you end up with like four people, two in each seat. It's kind of funny. Yeah, exactly, it just needs the detail, they just need to finish it. I mean, it's all there, you know, like all the windows are there, all the stuff's there, even the floor looks like it's pretty much done. You can see like the back seat there. There's the microwave or something. I don't know. There's the bed. There's the top hatch. You can, you know, I've actually looked at the air show. Got to look out that thing. They let us look out. It was cool. So it's all there. It's just a matter of like finishing it. I'm just surprised they didn't finish it. It's weird. It's a weird business decision. Like, well, we can sell them the whole hot dog, we'll sell them half. Like, it's just like, okay, man, like, and then when you see the outside, you're like, wow, I mean, they did a great job on the outside. So maybe they planned to finish it, and maybe somebody quit, or so you never know. And they were strapped. Like, man, we're got $10 and a gallon of milk is like $7 now, so I literally really is here in California. It must be over the bombing range, I think. Yeah, that would be awesome if I got in it and it was like some update. They keep on updating it, so there is a chance that they might, maybe they'll make enough money on it, because people like me are streaming it and recommending it, and then people see it, and maybe more and more people will be like, it actually is cool, and buy it or something. Oh yeah, that's a good price, $3.99, hell yeah. Yeah, everything's like double whatever you pay. Like a box of Kraft macaroni and cheese, $2.29. I live in Sacramento where it's cheaper too. I can imagine like the Bay Area. Cool, when you do a little zoom in too, kind of gives it the background blur a little bit. Looks super realistic. Yeah, I think it'd be bad by then. Could you imagine, like, if it's that much here, how much it is in Hawaii? $15 or something. They always have the highest fuel prices ever, man. I'm always, like, shocked when I go there. Of course, I mean, that's where I am right here now. Just shock. It's like, are you kidding me? because the air show started a couple months, so. It's my favorite time of the year, March through October. Screw winter. Winter is no fun. This isn't like a fighter jet, you know, you kind of like, you're like, well, I mean, now I'm up here. What do I do? Share the cockpit again. Talk about how it needs to be modeled. Here's the cockpit. Man. You got the lighting kind of fluctuating through there. It's kind of cool. It's like the pilots don't move either. They're just statues. They didn't see, the thing is like they didn't need to add the pilots, because if you have the pilots already set, like most people do for Microsoft Flight Simulator, they would have put your pilot in there. So like mine's like the Hernandez guy or whatever, he was in the front seat. I had to turn it off because they're just sitting on top of each other, which is kind of weird looking. It was really funny when you looked through the front from the outside view and then you saw them all sitting on top of each other. You're like, what is going on in this cockpit? Oh my god. Right? Yep. It's like, it really is. Well, you know, we started taking flight lessons and like, right away, the dude's like, oh yeah, you guys are in Flight Simulator for sure, because you already know everything. It's like, yeah, because you know, you learn everything. Oh yeah, we're starting to get in more towards Vegas. It's dry. It's a cool area though. I imagine any minute we'll start seeing some fighter jets. Mark my words. See, one thing they changed for sure is like around a lot of the lakes and stuff. It's like broken and rigid and rounded like the way it should have been, where it used to be like kind of squared off. So it really changed the look from there, obviously. I don't know exactly where it is. We're probably right kind of aligned with it, because I know it's flying over the bombing range and over the other thing. Was like over the route, so I don't know. I don't have the assisted guide on. I don't think it has Area 51 listed though. I did download and added the bombing range and then the other two airports that you can have the test range or whatever. I still don't know exactly where they are. I'll find them though. I'm gonna go out, take the F-22 out, and fly around, and find all that stuff, because that thing is badass. maybe I'll take the F-35 and hover. Well, the F-22 can basically hover with the stupid way it does the high alpha. Yeah, see, the modeling is really good. There's the lines are just true. Yeah, it looks really good. Well, you know, if you're watching this and you're on the fence about getting this, I mean, you can see it's worth the money. It really is. It's not bad. And this is one of the skins that I downloaded. There's a bunch of different ones that you can get. So. The skin looks really clean too. Whoever made it did a great job. The images were definitely high def. Maybe like one or two I don't have. Now that I got the top lock, that was the one that I didn't have. But pretty much every time one comes out, I end up buying it. So. I wish they put these jets in DCS. Although they do have a modded C-130 in DCS, that's pretty good. I don't know if the outside's as good as this though. This one's really good. The outside modeling. Zoom on in. I was rocking the Coast Guard livery earlier. That one was cool too. You can see it coming at us. Some Air Force advertisements with this thing. Oh, the Block 4 F-35. Yeah, it's like 72 new upgrades for it. That thing's insane. A lot of people don't like the F-35. I don't know why. That's one of the best jets. It's also the loudest jet too, by the way. Air shows, that thing is by far the loudest jet. It's like the Motley Crue of bands. It's a cool view too, like under the wing. It's stable too. You're like not rocking. So like if the GoPro is attached to the wing. Kind of see my wing flex too, that's pretty good. They got this right, man. You know, I hope they make a bunch of money on it and they make some more planes that have cockpits. That's all I can say, man. It's like this jet, and with the timing of them remodeling the ground too, it's just, you could probably make a movie or something with this stuff. Just think if you had like a newer computer too, because my computer's getting old now. Around in the 40s, I have a 30. drink real quick. That's really good. Do the zoom in like that too. Wow. You take screenshots of this and people would think it was real. Check out. I saw up in a plane and this flew by me. Oh yeah, the real Tesla. Yeah, Nikolai. Yeah, he had some amazing ideas. And then he died like a broke dude. Here's my guys. Hey, what's up, guys? Making pretty good time. I made it this far in autopilot too, I gotta give it that. Oh, I'd have to log in, I'd have to log out of the game completely. Need a reboot to have it do it. It is kind of funny though, because they're sitting on each other's laps. I'd have to like, yeah, literally like shut the game off and then restart it to get them to show up. Because yesterday, when I figured it, I was like, why are they doubled? I was like, oh, it's because the guys are in the seats. And then I tried to remove them and they wouldn't remove until I obviously restarted the game. So they were in there the whole time. You can see the modeling where they didn't. They have the color split, but they did blend them together a little bit better now, I noticed, with that last update. I think at some point they'll get to where the ground just looks exactly real. Yeah, you can see the split right there. Yeah, I can't get on that. It just won't stay on that camera. There's anything out there. I feel like 10 different camera angles, but I can't get on the one I want. Sweet. It just automatically changes back to the other one. Oh well. I like the sun. Yeah, they have the animals and stuff too. birds and everything. I don't know why they can't take it one step further and make it like a ground game too. Like you could buy property. Like I could buy my house in this game. Have a car, drive. I mean, you can have a car in this game. You can buy the car and drive around. A lot of the roads don't work and stuff. They'd have to remodel the entire ground, but man, then that would be a real game. Because that's the one thing, like people are like, Microsoft Flight Simulator is boring. If you're not totally into flying, which I'm totally into flying, then yeah, I could see where it would be pretty boring. Because what is there to do if you're not into flying? There are the missions and stuff, though. You can do all the missions. And there's the Reno Air Race add-ons. There's a lot of stuff you can do, but let's see, drop in here. Yeah, it'd be like The Sims. Except for your whole world, you have the whole world. Like, you could literally have everybody, there's every house. Like, my house is in, you know, it's in this game. Like, we're in the bottom of it. Well, that's a trip. Because I'm in the chase cam or whatever, so it's like, the jet's moving, so it's kind of bobbing up and down. That looks cool, though. These two guys. It's like, they're twins. You're like a pack of Twinkies. That is like one of the coolest views, though, because those windows like that. And then the ones below you, too, you can actually see below you. Like, what other jet has that? Or not jet, plane. It's not a jet. I keep calling it a jet because everything I usually fly is a jet. So the pilot can actually look down and then see the ground by his feet. Which apparently is something that was needed. Let's see, they have the tops upholstered or something. Yeah, they're like Twix bars, dude. They're just the same. Looks cool the way the ground's like kind of just floating by. Oh man. One thing it would be cool to see Microsoft Flight Simulator do is update the camera controls, because they're clunky, so you gotta like do a bunch of stuff to get the right angle and everything, and like while you're doing that you're recording and you see all that, you know, so it's, I don't know, I think DCS has better camera angles in my opinion, just the way you can do a couple camera angles where you can like have the jet fly right at you and all that and then chase it. You can't really do that with Microsoft Flight Simulator that well. Hey, what's up, one man? How you doing? We are flying the Hercules C-130 from Travis Air Force Base, California to Las Vegas, Nellis Air Force Base. And we're probably about 75% of the way there now. Because we're over the, I think it's, we're actually over the bombing range now. Yeah, it does, you're right. The big planes, because they're so big too, they look slower. Well, they are slower. Unless it's like the B1, they can go supersonic. B1 and B2, the stealth bombers. Those things are cool when you fly them by air shows. But I really do like watching the heavies, man. Those things are cool. Plus, those are cool because they park them. Because you can go climb through them and, like, you know, it's like a jungle gym, basically. Really, it's like, it's a lot of fun. Whereas, they don't let you, you know, near the F-16 or the F-15. Sometimes they have a little platform you can get up and, like, kind of look in the cockpit, but that's about it. Like the Raptor and the F-35, they have it like fenced off. You can't get anywhere near it unless you're like part of the media tour, which I was this year, so I was able to get right next to them. But normally I'm the dude on the other side of the fence. Starting to look like low altitude to me. That's when I start thinking it's time to take Mr. Autopilot off here. Yeah, see, it's getting pretty low. Oh, well, this year, I was able to go because I have YouTube. Like, now I can use the, oh, I have, well, I guess I have 300,000 now, but at that point, I only had 100,000, and they were like, oh, yeah, we'll give you a media pass. Like, a lot of it, you just have to reach out to people and be like, hey, by the way, currently, I work for the city of Santa Cruz, and I live in Sacramento, so, yeah, it's great, let me tell ya. Commuting. That's why I said I have no time all the time, because I'm always driving here. Yeah, I'm still going down. And I pressed the Alt-Z or whatever, it's like it should've... It's not really letting me pull up or anything. Yeah, starting to get lower. Great. It's like, yeah, it appears to be stuck in autopilot. It's not letting me pull up. It's not letting me do anything. There's no runway up there or anything. I mean, what? There's more mountains. What is it doing? Great. See, this is why. But you couldn't... How... Like, what would you do? It's like, you're going to fly this whole thing? You'd have to have some auto... Like, there's no pilot in the world, like, that takes this trip that doesn't use autopilot at some point. See, is it letting me pull up a little bit? It doesn't. It's not... It looks like it's going down. Yeah, look, it's like descending. Great. Well. And then here comes a mountain. Sweet. I feel like it's just not letting me pull up at all. It cleared that. I'm like trying my keyboard. It's just not letting me. I don't know. It doesn't seem to have any effect. I have to go into the assists, I guess. Let's see, where are we? Yeah, see, because we're not even near. That's real low, too. Is it going to make it over this? Oh, it's got this, man. Let's just let it go. I don't think it's... It looks like it's angling down more. Great. Oh, man. I have it key mapped to this one thing, too. That's not doing it. And then it's even got it on my flight stick right here. It's got the little A for autopilot. It's like they literally made it a button. It's not doing anything. Let's see. My fuel's fine, so I'm not out of gas or anything. In assist. Yeah, see, autopilot, I turned it off. It was on. Again. It's probably because I'm just turning it back on and off. It's not letting me do anything. It's just stuck. Going straight. Sweet. Well, I'll have to use the DAW if it crashes. Let's see. Yeah, it's off. Let me turn everything off. Nothing. Dead in the water. Try to turn it back on? I don't know, man. This is great.
Let this be a lesson to you. So you two ever use the autopilot.
Oh, this is going right for the mountain, too, man. Ah, dude. Well, we'll get to see what happens when it hits a mountain. There's no damage in Microsoft Flight Simulator. If you have the damage on, it just ends your session. I don't have it on, though. Because it just ends your session, which is freaking annoying. Yeah, it's like... Has no impact. Ooh, I just made it over that. It's not letting me do anything. Doesn't matter if it's on or off. Just kidding. Yeah, a little low. A little low. Oh! He bounced over the cliff. Oh, yeah, there you go. Oh, no. Oh no! Oh! We've crashed. Thank you, autopilot. Thank you for your service. Look how the autopilot is still going. It's gonna take back off, man. It's got a package to deliver. What is it gonna do? Take off right here? Dude, it still won't stop. The throttle's not even on. Oh, I like the dirt trail though. That's cool. That's some good modeling right there, man. They didn't really used to do that. That's awesome. I guess they must have just added that or something. Yeah, maybe I can't take off again. I'm not controlling it, though. It's just doing this. I have no control over it. Whoa, just jump. I'm going to have to just do the dot. Whoa. This is great. No, AI does not quit, man. Look, it's still going. It's got a package to deliver. Let's see, we'll just go to DAW and pull it up. Yeah. That was too funny. What the hell, dude? I wonder if it's going to give me control of it now, though. No, it's not. It's just dead. It's got nothing now. Look at that one's in a dive, too. This is great. Oh, yeah, sweet. right here. You can set up in the key mappings, you can do the dog, you can like pull it up and down, and then I mean normally if you drop it and you have your accelerator on, it'll be at power, but for some reason it wasn't working for me. Now it seems to be working. Oh, there we go. Okay, so maybe it was in the view that I was in, it just wasn't letting me because I was in that camera view. Because now it seems to be. Now I can actually fly the jet. This is too much. Yeah, Elon. I love the threads that are like, Elon for president. It's like, he wasn't born here. That means he can't be president. Well, we're back. Sweet. Alright, so I think, you know what? I think it was my own fault. I think it's because I was in that camera view that, and even though I was like coming out of autopilot, it just wouldn't let me control it still. So just was just letting me watch the plane fly into the cliff, basically. Sweet. Because obviously I should have been able to pull up. Because now I can hear everything, so. So yeah, well, I think we'll stay in manual control the remainder of the flight. We're not that far out anyways. This is normally when I start to see people around this area. I don't mean people, I mean like fighter pilots. Oh, did I speak too soon? What do we got here? Oh, nothing. I thought I heard something. Let's see, what is it on? Is it on? No. What if I put it on? What does it do? It swerves. What's it doing? Bro. What is up with autopilot? Where was it going? Like, literally, it was gonna take me back or something? I mean, you can see the line where we're going. What the hell, man? Oh, man. Try to ruin my flight here. Yeah. You pretty much can land anywhere. And take off. Well, that should have never happened, though. It shouldn't have. I should have been able. I should have figured that out. That, like, oh, I'm in that one camera angle. I can't do anything when I didn't realize that you couldn't do anything when you were in that one camera angle. Because you can't control the jet. So. Or, in this case, plane. Seems pretty slow when you're up here like this. We're almost there, though. Oh, those are all airports. Like all those purple things. Or pink, I guess. The pink and the blue. And then all the white is like, those are all other people playing. Those are all planes. You can see there's planes around me, so. We'll probably get an escort in. No, I doubt it. We'll probably see some fighter jets, though. Jet right there. What is that, F-22? Looks like it. It's hard to tell from here. No, he's coming back around. Maybe we are getting an escort. We deserve it after that flight. So that's a cool thing about Microsoft Flight Simulator. If you do have the multiplayer on, you get to fly with people. There actually will be a number of people flying, so. I just wish they had like the ATC set up better. Yeah, well, I'm flying because I don't have the damage on. If you have the damage on, just end your session the minute you hit the ground. That doesn't actually show any explosion or anything. Escort, baby. There you go, F-15. If you follow the line, it's not really the flight path to land at the runway, but it's just where the next sit, where the airport is. Yeah, that was cool as hell, the F-15.
Las Vegas Approach Badger 0811. Request
he's right there still.
Transition Bravo Airspace.
Badger 0811.
Probably land with me, I bet. See, that's what I think I'm gonna do. Do a late night session. come back on and fly the F-1022 because there's a bunch of people out here. Yep, see, he is right there. He's right off my way. He is escorting me all the way. That's hella cool, man. He must have this model because there's no way you would escort him. 747, because that's probably what it made me, like the generic Airbus or whatever. It just would look cool. There goes another jet. There's a couple. See, there's a bunch of people out here. That is cool how, like, the pilots actually hang out by the Air Force bases. So we left Travis, they were out there flying. First for me, I don't think I've had anybody like escort me all the way like this. Of course, I'm usually the person in the fighter jet though, so. So another huge like, hell yeah, I bought this jet. I'm stoked. This one was worth it. Alright, now I gotta start getting serious about this landing here. Let's see if I get my flaps down. Roll them down here. You can see they extend way down, it's pretty cool. Got the animations right for that because those flaps on the C-130 come way down. If you've ever seen them, it's rad. Oh yeah, I got this. It's no problem. We come over a little bit. We're losing airspeed. Got another jet in front of us. Oh well, he's landing too. It's like a lot of traffic. This is pretty cool. Pretty fast. A little fast here. I got no reverse. I got no reverse thrust. Dang it. I thought I paired that right too. That's the cool thing about the C-30 is that that was cool, man. This is night vision, bro. This is during the day. Well, I was still perfectly able to land. It wasn't the beautifulest landing, but I did have a lot of distractions going on. It's pretty cool distractions, though. Wow, that was awesome, man. We got escorted in by a couple F-15s. What a cool flight. Even the crash was funny. I don't know what the hell happened. That was funny as hell, but here you can see the AI piloting was off for the landing. We're putting it back on to see if it'll taxi the runway. And no, it's not doing anything. Let's turn it back off. Let's see. I see. I need to know which. Oh, what? It just killed. My engine just died. And I have this FAT behind me. This is great. I think that's the end of the stream here. Yeah, that was good. This was awesome. Anyways, I really appreciate everybody watching. I guess I killed the jet somehow. I don't know what I did. Anyways, I don't think I'm gonna get it to work. The tax room is off, it's just dead here in the water. Because I'm pressing the startup again and it's not, the engines aren't starting up or anything. That's weird, man. Here comes the F-15. Oh well, it was a cool stream, man. Hell yeah, I'm gonna come back in and get on a fighter jet and play with these guys. Anyways, thanks for checking this out. Really appreciate it.